Let's try modeling this capture hook. It has a main flat face, flanked with two flanges on the sides. There are a few ribs here and here. The important thing to take note is that the thickness of the part is maintained throughout. I'm going to take an unconventional approach here and use the shell command. The main aim of this video is not really to find the fastest way, but rather to explore the potential of the shell command. If we look at the final model, there is a simple overall shape. I prepared here a block which represents that shape. This is basically an extrude of this sketch. I've also added some fillets. I will leave a link for you to download this starting model. The ends of the two flanges have a distinct trapezium shape. In the file, I have prepared a sketch that defines that shape on this front face. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select this face to split, and select the sketch as a splitting tool. Make sure to select all the relevant segments of the sketch. We will not be able to select multiple sketches here. So let's confirm and repeat the command. We are now ready to perform the first major shell operation. Go to Modify, Shell. Remove the tangent chain option so that we can select individual faces. In order to decide which faces to select, you will need to imagine how the final model will look like and choose the faces that you want to open up. Basically, you will be selecting the faces that will not be there in the final model. Adjust the thickness. For direction, we shall set to inside, so that the outer dimensions of the main block are maintained. So we have achieved a thin wall structure that is very close to what we need. For this rib, it might be possible to perform some sort of a sweep or maybe even a root surface. I will leave that for you to try. I'm going to continue with the theme of this video and use the shell command again. Before that, we need to selectively thicken these faces. If we use the offset command, we will be forced to thicken this wall also, which is not ideal. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Offset. Remove the Chain Selection option, and create copies of these faces by setting the offset distance to 0. Go to Create, Thicken, and thicken the new surface body. Set the operation to Join, so that it joins with the main body. create a simple sketch on this face to trim off the excess. Perform an extruder cut through all. Mirror this extrude onto the other side. Activate the Solid tab and begin the Shell command. Select these faces and set the same shell thickness. Because we have set the same shell thickness, this portion of the wall remains unaffected, and material has been removed in a very neat fashion, leaving only ribs along the edges. We now have to create a similar feature on this side of the flange. As before, we need to add some thickness back before we can shell. Let's perform a sketch on this face. This straight line represents the extent of the rib. Draw two arcs and make them tangent at these four points. Project these two edges to close the profile. Begin an extrude with this profile. For extent type, set to two object and select this face. Begin the shell command. Select these faces and set the same shell thickness as before. After experimenting with this a few times, I find that there is some inconsistency with the behavior. There will be times where the shell command will return an error. In these cases, you can try to adjust the radius slightly. If you refer back to the picture shown in the Reddit post, you can see that there are openings here. My guess is that this is an injection molded part, and these openings are needed in order to produce these faces, which form an undercut. If you intend to 3D print this, the openings are not required.